He's on fire.
What a block. Deanna's win.
It goes to Rose, who beats him down.
That's 6-8 on the run.
Jalen Rose with a remarkable second quarter.
Nobody catching up with Jalen Rose tonight. Having a fantasy ball game.
Next. Game two would turn into a classic. The Pacers took a late fourth quarter lead behind Miller, who finished with 30 points.
That was a good shot for Reggie Miller.
Milwaukee staged a furious rally, but still trailed by three in the final seconds until they got the ball to Ray Allen.
Here's Allen firing to the tie!
Indiana still had 5 seconds left, and they turned to Reggie for the victory. But the Pacers came up short, and this dramatic game went into overtime. In the OT, Milwaukee took a one-point lead, but the Pacers had a chance to pull it out.
One-hander, the tip, it's good! With 5 tenths of a second!
You gotta give them a lot of credit. We faltered down the stretch, and that's our fault. But we were glad and gutsy to come up with the big victory.
Making their first playoff appearance in 8 years, the 76ers headed to Orlando to take on Penny Hardaway and the Magic. And Allen Iverson showed he was ready for the postseason.
The runner in the lane is good. Allen Iverson now with 9 points.
Allen had 18 in the first half and got his teammates involved.
Iverson fouled Larry Hughes.
But Orlando would make a run as their defense led them to some easy baskets.
Armstrong makes it a one-point game.
But Philadelphia responded as Matt Geiger scored 26 points.
Flips it up and puts it in. Geiger off balance.
And the Sixers took game one.
Underneath the snow, and a foul. Eric Snow puts it in.
We were ready for him. Came out real strong in the fourth quarter, played our good solid D that we played all year, and we got the victory.
The Magic knew they couldn't afford to lose 2 straight games at home. And in game two, they built a 21-point lead behind Penny Hardaway.
And Penny Hardaway on a run.
The Sixers made a run of their own to cut Orlando's lead to 7.
Lynch beat Hughes.
But Orlando came up big on both ends of the court and held on to even the series at a game apiece as they head to Philadelphia.
And here comes Hardaway with a breakaway.
Tough matchup for us. You know, they're well coached, and they're going to come back game three fired up, and their fans are going to be very loud.
Now let's take a look at the first round playoff picture in the Eastern Conference. The number one Miami Heat are tied with the Knicks at a game apiece as the series heads to New York. While the fourth seeded Atlanta Hawks hold a 2-game-to-none lead over the Pistons and will go for a sweep in Detroit. The third seeded Orlando Magic and Philadelphia 76ers are knotted at a game apiece. While the second seeded Indiana Pacers lead the Bucks 2-game-to-none as the scene shifts to Milwaukee.
When you put your arms around me, I feel so satisfied. I want to love you forever. Every time I turn around, I'm back in love again.
Back in love again. See right, see right.
I'm back in love again.
Back,
oh yeah.
In love again.
It doesn't need sugar, cause it's already.
Now let's go back into the action in the Western Conference playoffs. Starting with the Portland Trailblazers Phoenix Suns series. After losing in the first round of the playoffs 6 straight years, Portland was looking for a hot start at home against the Suns. And no one was hotter than Isaiah Rider, who would burn the Suns all game long as he led the Blazers attack with 25 points.
JR, tough fall-away shot.
Jason Kidd scored 17 and helped put Phoenix on top in the fourth quarter. But then Ryder took over once again.
Now Ryder in the front court, moves around Chapman, fouled on his way to the hoop, hit the shot and was fouled.
And the Trailblazers pulled away to capture a 10-point victory in game one.
Oh man, are you missing a party at the Rose Garden?
And Portland was feeling good at the start of game two, taking a 16-point lead.
Grant to Wallace underneath the rim.
Thanks to 15 points off the bench from rookie Pat Garrity, the Suns came to within 5 at halftime. But Portland broke it open in the third quarter and went up 2-0.
Damon in the front court.
Long three for the Jam! Ooh, that was nasty!
The Rose Garden is happy.
They're a dangerous team. You got to get long rebounds. We did that tonight. You know, at the end, we slipped up a little bit, but for the most part, we played well.
John Stockton and the veteran Jazz hosted rookie Jason Williams and the Sacramento Kings in Game 1. And Utah showed their playoff experience as they overwhelmed the Kings right from the start. The Jazz raced out to a 23-point lead in the first half.
Little hesitation, and then with a left hand. And the veterans for the Utah Jazz, Hornacek, Stockton, Malone, they're playing at the highest of levels.
And so was Greg Ostertag, who scored a career playoff high 16 points in Utah's blowout.
We felt that we didn't play up to our potential, and we're going to make it a better game come Monday.
In Game 2, the Jazz looked to continue their dominance. But forward Chris Webber, playing despite a back injury, was a force inside as he led Sacramento to a 13-point lead in the first half. Utah would counter with their running game.
Anderson blows by everybody!
With the Jazz up by two at halftime, the Kings responded with some timely outside shooting.
This is a young team growing up right in front of our eyes.
And down the stretch, Weber's inspired play sealed Sacramento's 11-point win that tied the series at a game apiece. Woo!
They have the home court advantage now, and that's what they came here for. That's just the way it works.
Now let's get you back into the action in the Western Conference playoffs with the San Antonio Spurs-Minnesota Timberwolves series. The Spurs finished with the NBA's best record, but the eight-seeded Timberwolves were looking to pull off the upset in Game 1.
We should have confidence going in, knowing that basically that we can go in, we can rebound with them, and if we can cut down on our turnovers and make plays, that, you know, we have a chance to win in here.
And with Sam Mitchell scoring 19 points, Minnesota led in the third quarter. But the Spurs' Tim Duncan was too much, scoring a game-high 26.
Oh, Duncan!
Avery Johnson added 21 as he and Duncan led San Antonio to a 99-86 victory in Game 1.
He goes up for first throw-up, no good. Duncan catches and slams it!
In Game 2, Kevin Garnett and the Timberwolves were determined to bounce back. But they fell behind early as the Spurs triggered their fast break, and Duncan was there to finish things off.
Finds Duncan trailing for the slam.
But after that, it was all Minnesota as Terrell Brandon scored 18 points to lead a balanced attack. The T-Wolves stunned San Antonio by winning Game 2, 80-71, tying the series at a game apiece.
Peeler trains a three. That's the way the night has gone for Minnesota.
We're playing good basketball. No, we executed. We came out, we played aggressive for 48 minutes, which was the difference in Game 1.
Next up, in Los Angeles, it was Shaquille O'Neal and the Lakers against Hakeem Olajuwon and the Houston Rockets. And in the first half, Glenn Rice ignited L.A.
That's beautiful basketball.
But Game 1 became a close battle. And with a minute left, Hakeem gave Houston a two-point lead.
Green turns and lays it up and down.
Do it a foul!
Kurt Rambis's Lakers went back on top by one. But the Rockets had the ball. Had one more chance to pull it out at the finish.
He's got there under the basket. Shaq blocks the shot. Game. Set. Match. The Lakers win it.
We can't turn the ball over, especially in crucial situations. My guys played well. It was a good game. We just got to tweak a couple of little things and we'll be fine.
In Game 2, the Lakers took control right from the opening tip with a total team effort.
Back into Kobe!
What a great two-man game they played there.
This time, it wasn't even close. L.A. took a 19-point lead in the first quarter behind the shooting of Derek Fisher, who hit 4 3-pointers.
Fisher is red hot.
Rolling to victory, the Lakers went up 2-0, led by 28 points from Shaq.
Everything is dropping for Shaquille O'Neal tonight.
O'Neal is on a roll. He is on a major roll, riding a wave and riding it hard.
Now let's check out their first-round playoff picture in the Western Conference. The top-seeded San Antonio Spurs are tied with the Timberwolves at a game apiece. The fourth-seeded L.A. Lakers lead the Rockets 2-0. The third-seeded Utah Jazz are even with the Sacramento Kings at a game apiece. And the second-seeded Portland Trail Blazers are two games up on the Phoenix Suns.
This is NBA basketball at its best.
It's O'Neal! Bounce pass for Reed. Slams it all.
Jason with a long pass up the floor. Oh,
oh
what a
my
pass!
God.
Kevin Garnett.
It's Armstrong. That's outlaw.
Time now to log on to NBA.com, where we begin with a late season signing in Minnesota. The Timberwolves signed their first round draft pick, Radoslav Nesterovic, who's from Slovenia. The NBA now has 40 international players from 26 countries, and Minnesota hopes their new big man will make an immediate impact.
How good he'll be, I don't know, but I have a feeling that he can be very good in the NBA for a lot of years.
Meanwhile, the Charlotte Hornets signed Paul Silas as their coach for the next 4 years. Silas took over as interim coach in March and guided the Hornets to a 22-13 record, including 9 straight victories. Next up, the latest NBA honors. Atlanta Hawks center Dikembe Mutombo was named as the winner of the 1999 IBM Award.
Mutombo got trailer right out of the way. Whoa. And dunks it home.
The award uses a computerized rating to measure a player's contribution to his team. And Mutombo was a force for the Hawks, ranking third in the league in rebounding and fourth in block shots. Also, the Orlando Magic's Darrell Armstrong was named the winner of the NBA Sixth Man Award.
Armstrong on the drive, scoops it up and in.
Armstrong gave the Magic a spark off the bench as he helped lead them into the playoffs.
It feels good, and I'm just happy that my teammates can share it and I can share it.
All right, now it's time for our viewer email. This week's question comes to us from Gabriela Gonzalez of San Jose, Costa Rica, who asks, when was the first NBA All-Star game played? In 1951, the Celtics' Bob Cousy led the East, while the Lakers' George Mikan represented the West in the premier NBA All-Star game at Boston Garden. And the East ran away with it, winning it 111-94.
They've got the apple. Bob Cousy with a wonderful brand of dribbling.
Now, we take a look at the final NBA leaders from the regular season in overtime. The Philadelphia 76ers, Allen Iverson, is this year's NBA scoring champion.
Iverson, the backcourt cut. Long play by Allen Iverson as he wrapped it around the rim and twirled it home.
Winning his first league scoring title, Iverson averaged nearly 27 points a game. He beat out LA's Shaquille O'Neal in one of the closest scoring races in NBA history.
Oh! Play by Iverson!
I really don't think anybody could guard me. You know, not being conceited or anything like that, but that's just, you know, me believing in my ability.
The NBA's rebounding king was Sacramento forward Chris Webber, who averaged 13 boards per game.
Rebound, Chris Webber, back up and in.
It's the first time Webber's won the rebounding title. He also led Sacramento in scoring, and his strong inside play was a big reason why the Kings have made it to the playoffs.
Well, I just know I worked real hard this summer and in past summers, and what I try to do is I try to be a forward that can do everything.
And this season, Chris is doing it all.
Inside block by Gugliotta. Webber trying to reload it, and he got it.
Anything he sees that our team is lacking, he's going to step up in that category, whether it be rebounding, block shot, just diving on the floor. I mean, he's a great player, you know, take over a game anytime.
The assist title goes to Jason Kidd of Phoenix.
Jason Kidd, he's on the run. Jason down the left side, great feet to McLeod, reverse layup, good.
The Suns floor leader captured the title for the first time as he averaged nearly 11 assists per game. and foul the open man all season long.
Kid to go. He stops it.
And finally, the league's leading shot blocker was Miami Heat center Alonzo Mourning. Zo rejected nearly four shots per game and is a leading candidate for this year's Most Valuable Player Award.
Blocked by Mourning!
Do you believe that?
Now, the Orlando Magic guard and winner of the NBA Sixth Man Award is holding court.
Sprewell, rebounds and leads the play. You never saw Darrell Armstrong coming. Here goes the little fella. He throws it down.
He is all energy.
Again, the little guy. Again, the little guy.
Now Armstrong having a storybook season.
Darrell Armstrong was undrafted after college and played in pro leagues in the United States, Spain, and Cyprus before reaching the NBA.
My travels was a long road, but it was a fun road. It was a good experience because I went overseas for 2 years, played in the USBL, the Global Basketball Association, the CBA. So, I went through some leagues.
And we saw this little guy out there just diving on the floor, as fast as could be, hustling all over the place. Great defender.
And though he finally made it to the Magic, Darrell hasn't forgotten where he came from.
Just remember all them great days back, you know, back in the day when, you know, you never thought that it would end up right here. But, you know, like I say, if you don't stick with it, then you won't know what's going to happen at the end.
Now, Armstrong's been recognized as the NBA's top reserve after averaging 14 points and 7 assists this season.
Well, Darrell is awesome. I mean, he's a guy that you know when he comes out there on the floor, he's going to give you all that he has. He's going to change the tempo of the game in our favor.
Armstrong picks the pocket of Leonard, and he's off to the races.
Oh, how about that finish for Darrell Armstrong?
He's got a lot of talent, no question. He's a lightning rod, great energy, and loves to play, loves to compete.
Ball loose, Chicago hits it to the backcourt. Darrell Armstrong dives, saves to Harper. Do you believe that?
Oh, what a play. Man, oh, man, that's giving up your body.
Talk about Darrell as having a heart bigger than his chest. If you want a role model, anybody who plays the game who's younger, smaller, thinner, ought to look at Darrell Armstrong.
Stolen by Armstrong. Armstrong leaves it. He beats the ball.
It's all what you have inside yourself. If you believe in yourself, then trust me, you're going to do some things.
For the top 10 plays of the week in our courtside countdown. Starting things off at number 10, it's Glenn Rice of the LA Lakers.
Rice. Shot that one from somewhere in Santa Monica.
In at number 9, here's the scoring champ, Allen Iverson of the Philadelphia 76ers.
Iverson for two. Yes! There you go.
Nice move by the 76ers, swinging the ball around, finding Allen Iverson open on the left side.
Checking in at number 8, here's the Detroit Pistons' Joe Dumars to Jerry Stackhouse.
One, pass,
by Joe Dumars.
Beautiful pass, Joe. Talking about right on the money.
Coming in at number seven, it's this play by forward Chris Webber of the Sacramento Kings.
Webber on the drive and a power slam for 14. That had a little adrenaline and anger on it.
In at number six, here's Penny Hardaway of the Orlando Magic.
Hardaway, tough shot, puts it over. Beautiful move from Penny Hardaway.
That's a tough shot.
At number five, it's Isaiah J.R. Ryder of the Portland Trail Blazers.
Time running out. J.R. at the horn. He's going to get it. And he is going to have a pass. Oh! Can I get a witness?
At four, it's the Lakers' Shaquille O'Neal to Kobe Bryant.
Lob for Kobe! It's another thing of beauty.
At number three, once again, it's Kobe Bryant.
Bryant drives by Dickerson and hits the reverse. They don't give extra points for degree of difficulty, but the fans appreciate it.
Act two, check out this great teamwork by the Sacramento Kings.
Jason Williams, behind the back, Webber, Traylor, Williamson, wow!
Oh, the young fella got a little flavor in his game.
And the number one play of the week goes to the Blazers, Walt Williams.
Oh, Walt Williams, are you kidding me? Showing no talent.
Walt Williams is doing some wicked good tonight.
That's our show for today. Thanks for watching. Remember, you can send us your questions or comments at the league's official website, NBA.com. I'm Jim Fagan for NBA Action. See you next week.